All right, guys, back with another Fuckery Friday. And yes, there is a stain on my shirt. Yes, I'm aware of it. I have children. I just dropped them off. So, fuck it, we'll do it live. Here's the deal. Fortunately, this stain corresponds exactly to the topic we're going to talk about today. One of the things I hear a lot is that obesity is just overeating by 20 calories a day. That stain's probably about 20 calories. So, we're right in line with the topic for today. But I wanted to examine this a little bit more because if you look at weight gain over the course of adulthood amongst the average person who becomes obese, it is about 20 calories a day if you break it down back to an energy equivalent. Now, there's multiple problems with this. And one of them is that it leads people like Gary Taubes to say, well, see, if obesity is only 20 calories a day, it means that if you were maintaining your weight at like a really low calorie level, like 1200 calories, that you could eat 1220 calories and over time become obese if your insulin was just high enough, bruh. There's a lot of problems with this line of thinking. The first major one is that it assumes people gain weight linearly. People do not gain weight linearly. In fact, if you look at the plethora of research data, we gain virtually all of our weight in America in a 1 month time period, the holidays. So from Thanksgiving to New Year's, the average person will put on around a half to 2 kilos, 0.5 to 2 kilos per year that they never take off during the rest of the year. That's not overeating by 20 calories a day. That's overeating by several hundred calories a day and then maintaining the rest of the year. So that's the first problem with that theory. The second problem with the theory, especially as the way Gary Taubes describes it, is if you consume more calories, what happens is that you don't perfectly deposit every calorie over maintenance that you eat. What happens is the more calories you consume, the more wasteful your body becomes with calories. So you end up giving off more as heat. Now, if you overeat enough, trust me, you'll end up gaining weight. But we know that NEAT, or non-exercise adaptive thermogenesis, is extremely variable from one person to another. In fact, they did a study where they looked at overfeeding people by 1,000 calories per day, and they found that weight gain was so diverse. In fact, most people gained a good amount of weight. Some people gained a lot of weight, and one person actually lost weight during the study. Now, it was a small amount, but still. So their energy expenditure was more than compensating for the amount of extra calories they were consuming. So if you're talking about something like 20 calories a day, especially for people who tend to just dissipate excess energy, you're not going to see linear increases in weight gain. It's going to be very individual. So the point being is that as you add calories, as you gain weight, you're not just going to keep gaining weight on the same calorie level. You are going to have to continuously increase calories. It's also important for you out there who want to gain muscle and have ever done a bulk before, you know that at a certain point you stop gaining weight and you have to add more calories in. That is adaptive thermogenesis. So, or metabolic adaptation in a, I guess, a positive direction. So this idea that just overeating by 20 calories a day is going to produce obesity is just complete nonsense. It's not something that can be boiled down quite so easily. Yes, it is energy in versus energy out, but as we've discussed multiple times, those two variables are extremely fluid. They change quite a bit, and one affects the other. So it's very hard just to nail down, oh, well, I'm gonna pick out 20 calories. I tell you what, if you try and cut 20 calories out of your diet and watch what happens, I promise you, nothing will happen. You will lose zero weight, at least zero long-term weight. We know this, intuitively we know this. If you want to lose weight, you have to make a pretty decent cut out of your calories. Part of that is because I think there's something called a maintenance range of calories where there's probably a 100 to 200 to 300 calorie range that you maintain your weight in. And that is probably determined by your level of adaptive thermogenesis. If you just cut 50 or 100 calories out of your diet, a lot of times you won't see any weight loss. You have to cut 200 or 300 or 400 calories out of your diet to see weight loss or weight gain. That's that maintenance range. So this idea that 20 calories is either going to help get us skinny again or make us fat is complete nonsense. And like I said, most of that weight gain comes in one period of time, which is during the holidays, which is why it's very important to practice really mindful behaviors during the holidays. And we're going to have some videos coming up during the holidays to help you guys with that. All right, guys, that's this week's Fuckery Friday. Hope you enjoyed it. Like the video if you liked the video. Please share it. And click the links in the description if you want to check out some of our merchandise. Hey guys, thanks for watching my video. If you like these videos, please click the links in the description to check out some of my educational books where you can learn more about fat loss and contest prep.